Now we go further, and we are reading and linking it to the this thing which we have already read it. And so here the standard I am reading and trying to explain you this. When different approaches, that point is very clear, friends. When the valuer is supposed to try just not one method, unless he is very, very thorough and confident about that method. So that means what? In general, you should try two methods, and that will based on which you can decide the price and allow other person also to see. You are not a gospel truth. You are trying to give based on the knowledge, information that is given to you. You don't have even that the authenticity of information is based on what is giving the corporate debtor or the interested party. Therefore, based on the data given, after applying your mind, you are going to give some subjective value. So it is always better to try two different methods, different assumptions from which you can look at it. Okay. So minimum two methods have to be considered is what we understand. Now the second part of our discussion will be, let's read that. He says that where more than one approach and method is used, or even multiple methods within a single approach, the conclusion of value based on those multiple approaches or methods should be reasonable, and the process of analyzing and reconciling the differing values into a single conclusion without averaging should be described by the valuers. Here there is second part. If you see, you approach even in a single method different approaches, or you are going for multiple methods and then you are getting different prices. You should be able to reconcile them. Why this price is 27 crores, or why this price is 270 crores, why the price you think it is 290 crores, and what is the difference. So I told you that custody discount for lack of control is one factor which you are going to adjust the main value. So therefore, why you are adjusting so much money, that is also a factor which you are supposed to consider. Next is, when different approaches and methods result in widely divergent indications of value, a valuer should perform procedures to understand why the value indications differ, as it is generally not appropriate to simply weight two or more divergent indicators of value. In such cases, valuer should reconsider whether one of the approaches or methods provides a better or more reliable indication of the value. You see, it's like that elections we are going. Somebody is telling this man will win, Congress party will win with 100 seats. And some other says BJP will win with 100 seats. That means extreme difference. So then it is not just taking average and then telling, okay, this is the thing. So the valuer should apply mind, and he should be in a position to convincingly understand himself. Thereafter, which method can be better? You understand? It's like strategies, you know. Pricing is a strategy, it's a profit. Every decision is aimed at profits. So therefore, they are saying you must remember that point extremely clear. Valuers should maximize the use of relevant, observable market information in all the three approaches. My example of case study will stand in all methods, friends, I am telling you. I can give you, as and when we go on, lot of methods, how we are approaching. I am approaching from the different angles, so that we are adding to standards are set by a lot of experts. They would have seen much more than us. So how are you going to understand what they were thinking in the form of some statements? Is this, valuers should maximize the use of relevant observable market information in all the three approaches, regardless of the source of inputs and assumptions used in the valuation. The valuer must perform appropriate analysis to evaluate those inputs and assumptions and their appropriateness for the valuation purpose. I told you, at the time when we started the game, somebody has told me this asset will get you only 80 crores, whereas the dues are about 200 crores. Now you can think, okay, 80 crores is coming, and then we'll secure credit card, you pay, and thereafter unsecured creditors will go away. Now you follow that procedures. The procedures in the code are meant for the lowest realizations, though they talk about the maximum realization. So then we went against this. What are the impediments? How do we market our product? Who can be sold? How to popularize ourselves? And is per as per the law. And slowly we were able to get. Today the price that we can realize is much more than the liabilities. So everybody will get 100%. We don't want more than that. You understand? So therefore, in all cases, if you take a thing, even I get suppose I am getting 100 crores. Today I am getting 100 crores, but I can also could have closed it at 30 crores, 40 crores, 50 crores, 60 crores. Ultimately, you must be an expert to understand, believe, and market, and convince, and realize, and then pay. So that is what is the international valuation standard 105 is talking about. Last paragraph. Although no one approach or method is applicable in all circumstances, price information from an active market is generally considered to be the strongest evidence of value. Some basis of value may prohibit the valuer from making subjective adjustments to price information from an active market. Price information from an inactive market may still be good evidence of value, but subjective adjustments need to be made. So if you have a market for the product price available, that is safer for you. As a liquidator, I can say at that point in time, my value is only this much, so I sold. I'm able to get lesser than that. Nobody can question you when you go through the process, but your ability lies in getting higher price. But studying the IV, International Valuation Standard 105, they are giving a broad approach. They decide that summary is that there are three methods. The method is market method, and then income method, and cost method. When do you apply these methods? Under what circumstances? How do you achieve the maximum realization? This is pricing is based on several inputs, several situations. So one thing is very clear, you should not go by one method. You should try and test different methods as applicable to the given situation. And the appropriateness of the method is your expert knowledge. Is your ability, when there is a huge divergence between the methods, your ability to reconcile them is also very, very important. And then appropriateness of the method you choose and declare, this will be the most right price. That is the values. You should be able to tell them, this is the value finally you should get or more. That is the subject. Thank you. First IV, International Valuation Standard 105 is over.